Amen, amen. Welcome to the house of God, brothers and sisters. This wonderful morning, amen, Resurrection Sunday, amen. We're going to stand to our feet this wonderful morning, amen. We're going to praise God with this very first song, Arise, Arise. Alive, alive. Yeah.
Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive, alive forevermore. Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah. My Jesus is alive forevermore. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah. My Jesus is alive. Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive, alive forevermore. Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah, sing hallelujah. My Jesus is alive forevermore. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah. My Jesus is alive. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah. My Jesus is alive forevermore. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah. My Jesus is alive.
Let's sing the next song. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glorify. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glorify the name of the Lord. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it. We are saved. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it. We are saved.
Blessed be the name of the Lord this morning.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glorify. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glorify. The Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it. We are saved. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it. We are saved.
Let's sing the next song. Come on and celebrate. Come on and celebrate.
His gift of love we will celebrate. The Son of God who loved us and gave us life. We shout your praise, O King. You gave us love, nothing else can bring. We give to you our offering. Celebration, praise.
Come on and celebrate.
Come on and celebrate. Celebrate. Celebrate and sing to the King. Come on and celebrate, celebrate, celebrate and sing. Celebrate and sing to the King.
Come on this morning,
come on and celebrate. His gift of love we will celebrate. The Son of God who loved us and gave us life. We shout your praise, O King. You give us life, nothing else can bring. We give to you our offerings. Celebration, praise.
Come on.
Come on and celebrate. Celebrate, celebrate and sing. celebrate and sing. Celebrate and sing to the King.
Amen. Let's lift the name up high of the Lord. Let's worship Him. And let's praise Him this wonderful morning. Oh God, we thank You, oh God. Lord, we worship You, oh God.
Oh yes,
amen,
Lord.
Amen. Thank We're going to slow it down this wonderful morning.
Oh,
amen. Let's come with a heart of worship and worship Him with this next song. Oh, Redeemer, Savior, Friend.
I know You had me on Your mind when You climb up on that hill. For You saw me with eternal eyes while I was yet in sin. Redeemer, Savior, Friend. Every stripe upon Your battered
back,
every tone that pierced Your brow, every nail drawn deep through guiltless hands, say that Your love knows no end. Redeemer, Savior, Friend. Oh, Redeemer. Oh, Redeemer. Redeem my heart again. Savior, come and shelter me from sin. You're familiar with my weakness, devoted to the end. Savior, Friend. Redeemer, Savior, Friend.
Oh, show the grace this morning.
Show the grace You pour upon my life. Will return to You in praise. And I'll gladly lay down on my grounds for the name by which I'm saved. For the name by which I'm saved. Oh, Redeemer, oh, Redeemer, redeem my heart again. Savior, come and shelter me from sin. You're familiar with my weakness, devoted to the end. Redeemer, Savior, Friend. Redeemer, Savior, Friend. Oh, Redeemer, oh, Redeemer. Redeem my heart again. Savior, come and shelter me from sin. You're familiar with my weakness, devoted to the end. Redeemer, Savior, Friend. Redeemer, Savior, Friend.
Redeemer, Savior, Friend.
Redeemer, Savior, Friend. Redeemer, Savior, Friend.
Let's worship the Lord this morning. Yes, oh Lord, You are our Savior, oh God. We worship You and honor You, oh God. We glorify You. Oh Lord, we thank You, oh God, Lord. Yes, You are worthy of all praise and glory, oh God. Let's worship Him with this next song. Oh, who taught the sun?
Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? Who told the ocean You can only come this far. And who showed a moon where to hide to even whose words alone can catch a falling star? Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let his life within me cry. I know my Redeemer lives. Very same God that spins things in the orbit, runs through the weary, the worn, the weak, and the same gentle hands that holds me when I'm broken, they conquer death to bring me victory. Oh, I know, well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let his life within me cry. I know my Redeemer lives. Well, I know this morning. Well, I know. Let his life within me cry. I know my Redeemer lives. Well, I know. Well, I know my Redeemer lives.
I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let his life within me cry. I know my Redeemer lives.
Well, I know this morning, hallelujah. Well, I know my Redeemer lives.
I know my Redeemer lives.
Let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry.
I know my Redeemer lives.
One more time. Well, I know. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives.
Let all creation testify.
Let his life within me cry.
I know my Redeemer lives.
I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let's give him a big clap offering. Hallelujah. Elarando corrobo shandara baba baba Sunday. Amen. Could you join your neighbor's hands? We want to pray. Amen. We want to pray together. And if you have a need this morning, just lift up your hands. And Father, we come before you in unity of heart, linking our hands together as a body of Christ this morning. You teach us in the Bible to ask from you. You teach us in your word to come before you and call upon your name. As this morning, as we stand before you, dear Father in heaven, we bring needs before you. We bring Brother Gunn before you. Mal had heart attack. We pray for his heart. God, you be the strength of his heart. We bring Jackie's husband before you, Brother Lucas. And we bring him before you. We ask that God, you do a miracle in his body, heal him from cancer. This morning in Jesus' name, we want to pray for all our leaders in the fellowship, Pastor Greg Mitchell, Pastor Joe Campbell, Pastor Eleanor Sear this morning as well. We bring all the churches represented in this nation of ours, the church in PJ, the church in USJ, the church in Sabah, the church in Sri Hartamas this morning, the church here as well. Unto you we surrender all the pastors, their families, their congregation before you. We ask that, Father in heaven, you protect, you set your angels around all of us, we pray. We want to bring our family members before you who are not saved. Father, have mercy upon them. Open the eyes of their heart that they may come to know you this morning. Open the eyes of their mind as well, that they may be able to see the truth, that there is a heaven and that there is a hell, and everyone who sinned will not make it to heaven. Open the eyes of their heart. This morning as well, we bring God Almighty, hallelujah, this morning, those who are not here, we pray for them, protect them wherever they are. In your name, we bring our King, we bring our Prime Minister before you. We pray for them, God, that you protect them, that you bless them, that you give them wisdom in ruling this nation of Malaysia in the name of Jesus. And everyone that's here this morning, we pray, God, that you bless everyone here as we come before you. Minister to us this morning through your word. In Jesus Christ's most mighty name we pray. Amen. Let's give a big clap to the Lord. Would you turn around, welcome one another. Amen. Hallelujah. And greet one another as we sing this song.
Celebrate.
Come on and celebrate. Come on and celebrate his gift of love. We will celebrate the Son of God who loves us and give us life. We'll shout your praise, O King. Celebrate and sing to the King. Come on and celebrate. Come on and celebrate his gift of love. We will celebrate the Son of God to love us and give us life. We'll shout your praise, O King. You give us life, nothing else can bring. We give to you our offerings. Celebration, praise. Come on and celebrate, celebrate,
celebrate
and sing. Let's give a big clap to the Lord this morning. Welcome you to the house of the Lord, and thank you very much, platform workers. Greatly appreciate your presence this morning, house of God. We'd like to give you first the announcement. The children is going to come up to present a song this morning. And before that announcement, tonight we have our evening bilingual service, English translated to Tamil at 7 p.m. And just take note, Wednesday we have our midweek worship service on the book of 1 Peter. We're doing a study from that book. And also note that on the second day of Hari Raya at 10:30 here, we're going to have a kids' discipleship. Okay? So we're going to gather the kids from our church, and we're going to have a children or kids discipleship. And I think there are six or seven of our kids here. And we're going to have a kids discipleship here in this place. And I have an assistant as well who's going to help me. Brother Elvin is going to help me. He's actually the assistant principal in a Christian school. So he is very knowledgeable in children. So we're going to have him assist me on that morning at 10:30 here in this place. Second day of Hari Raya, what date is that? 11th of April, okay? So 11th of April, Thursday morning at 10:30, we're going to have a kids discipleship here. And there are going to be activity, questions and answer. And I'm excited, okay? Never have done this before. So this is the first time we are doing it. So really ask you to pray for us, especially pray for me. Okay, never had this kind of things before. Okay, so on the 20th of April, we're gonna do a Gotong Royong community service. We did our first Gotong Royong a few months back, I think 3-4 months back. And we're going to do a second Gotong Royong here around with our uniform and then go around this place cleaning, doing community service, environmental, I don't know what's that word, environmental service, much like Alam Flora, you know, pick up all the rubbish, cleaning up the place. So the further details, Brother Luke will inform you. So it will be on the 20th. Of April, Saturday morning. Okay, we will let you know the time. We get it together later on. All right. So, 10 minutes after the service, I'd like to meet up with the mothers in my office. Okay, after your light refreshment, mothers, we like to meet up with you in my office to just. Discuss with you about Mother's Day service, okay? We're going to have a Mother's Day service and we want to plan something before that for Mother's Day. So I'd like to cordially invite all the mothers to come into my small little office, okay? We're going to have a short briefing. At the same time, those who are involved with choir, the choir group is going to sing in the May conference. You can meet up with Jasper for a short little practice as well, okay? So before that, we're going to invite the children, amen. Let's give them a big clap this morning. Yeah. Pulpit, okay, pulpit.
Bible, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, whoever believes in him shall not perish but have an eternal life. John 3:16. Amen. Our Almighty God. Our Almighty God loves us so much. He gave his only Son so that we may be called his children and that we may live in the gladness and in the grace on this Resurrection Sunday and every day.
Let us have a heart of thankfulness for his sacrifice. Let us have eyes that look upon his unfailing love, and let us rejoice in our salvation. help us to walk in His mighty grace and spread the good news to the world.
Yes, tell the word the good news.
Jesus Christ is Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, tell the word the good news. Jesus Christ is God. All God given to Him. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Let's give them another clap this wonderful morning. So again, we welcome you to the house of the Lord. Let's bow our heads. We're going to give to God this morning our offerings. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this great blessing that we can be here to worship you and honor you. This morning, we bring our offerings and bring our tithes before you. Almighty God, a blessed, cheerful giver, gives to you by faith. Everything we do it by faith. Everything you call us to do is to do it by faith, trusting that whatever we do, that you, Almighty God, at the end of the day, you will begin to honor, hallelujah, our act of faith. As we give to you, God, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. So, again, we do just want to welcome all of you for this morning's service. And if you have your Bible, I'd like you to turn with me to Luke chapter 24. Verse 1 to 11. I just want to inform you that every Saturday around 6, we set up a booth downstairs to outreach and to pray for people. The booth is called Need Prayers, and yesterday we prayed for a lady who came to the booth, and we are doing many things downstairs there to make ourselves visible, okay, to let the community here know that there's a church here, and if anybody needs help in prayer, going through problems in life, there's an answer, there's someone that can help pray for them. So we do encourage you to join the outreach team. Usually there are 4 or 5 of us there, and the more the better, the more we can make a better impact, okay? So continue to pray for the outreach group, okay, in your morning prayer, amen, in your prayers. So Luke 24, verse 1 to 11, will not take much of your time this morning. So Luke chapter 24, verse 1 to 11, if you could arise to your feet, we're going to read from verse 1 to verse 11. I read verse 1, you read verse 2. Now on the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they and certain other women with them came to the tomb, bringing the spices which they had prepared. Verse 2. Then they went in and did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. Then as they were afraid and bowed their faces to the earth, they said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead?" Verse 6. Saying, "The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and the third day arise again." Verse 8. Then they returned from the tomb, told all these things to the 11 and to all the rest. Verse 10. And their words seems to be like idle tales, and they did not believe them. Verse 12. Amen. Father, bless this morning message and service. Holy Spirit, needs you to help us here in this place. Your presence here is so important. Amen, we pray. Amen. You can be seated. So I would like to welcome all of you for this Sunday morning resurrection service. For Christian, basically there are two very important days that we consider as big days in the Christian calendar. And those days are Christmas and Resurrection Sunday. Though we do not know really on what day Christ is actually born, okay, but the point is he was born, and thank God Christ was born. If not, we will all die in our sins if he has not born or was not born. And that itself is a reason to why we have a day whereby we remember his birth, okay, Christmas Day. And the other special day is today, Resurrection Sunday, which is the third day after his death, which his death was on Friday, Good Friday, but on Sunday he arose again from the dead. If Christmas has not taken place, there will be no Resurrection Sunday. And if Resurrection Sunday had not happened, Christmas would have no meaning. If Resurrection Sunday had not happened, Christmas would be nothing more than a passing story of a good man who make an impact in his time, and that would be the end of it. Resurrection Sunday is that gives Christmas its true meaning. Now in our next year, we find that at a time called a very early in the morning time, the Bible tells us two women, one called Mary Magdalene, and the other, certain other woman, came with spices to anoint the body of Jesus Christ. Upon approaching the tomb, they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. And upon entering, was not able to find the body of Jesus, but instead was met with two men in shining garments, and being afraid upon seeing them, bowed their head before them, to next hear them saying to them these powerful words that gives hope to all of mankind. That is, why do you seek the living among the dead? He's not here, the angel says to these two women, but is risen. Which is what sums up what Resurrection Sunday is about. Which is about, he is not here, but is risen. Churches this morning all over proclaim this, celebrate this truth and fact that Jesus died and was buried, but did not remain dead in the tomb, but instead arise from the dead. The garments, the linen garments of death or death that was used to wrap him could not bind him. The decaying enzymes that was at work to decay his lifeless body back to dust has to reverse its work of decaying him. The stone of death that was used to prevent anyone from going in could not do so, but have to be rolled aside for him. He's not here. He has risen. Now, this is a big thing for you, again, because if Jesus has not risen, you are the most foolish to gather this morning here. But there is more to its meaning than just a hopeful event. Because when we look to God's word this morning, we see that it also means that our faith is not a futile faith or a hopeless faith or an ineffective faith. The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 17, the scripture says, and if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile, ineffective. You are still in your sins if Christ has not been raised. Then those also who have fallen asleep in Christ are lost. If only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. The word futile means having no effective results. And what Paul is saying is, if Jesus is still dead and still in the tomb, or if he did not rise again from the dead or come back to life, then our belief is of no use. It has no effective value in it. It cannot do anything for the person who hold on to it. It is of no effect. It is a pointless belief. As he says in 1 Corinthians, as the Bible says, verse 19, that we of all people are the most miserable. But this morning, our faith is not futile, for it is a faith that is effective. It is a profitable faith. It is a faith that brings benefit to those who believe, and it is an effective by reason of the one who on Good Friday was crucified, nailed on the cross, and his body was confirmed dead and was taken to be buried by a man by the name of Joseph, buried in a borrowed tomb, sealed with a huge stones, with guards guarding his tomb. But on Resurrection Sunday morning, when Mary Magdalene and the other woman came, they saw the stone roll away, two angels standing there saying, why do you seek the living among the dead? He's not here, but is risen. One very beautiful thing about being a Christian is that every one of us has a personal angel around us. Amen. We are not alone. Okay, wherever you go, you have a guardian angel that keeps watch over you, that is encamped around you to see that you are protected. So the two angels standing there saying, why do you seek the living among the dead? He's not here, but he is risen. In witnessing to people, I would always use this example. Okay, this way of witnessing to people about Jesus. And I say to them, if you know someone who's very good, someone that is very wise, someone that's very compassionate, someone that's very helpful, and you will always turn to him or her, and she will always or he will always give you good advice. He will always, you know, help guide you. Okay, he will always be there to answer your problems. But if he dies, what then happens is he dies with all the wisdom. He dies with all the goodness that he has with him. Okay, and if you have a problem, you can no more go to him because he's dead. But what if he rose again from the dead? What if he comes back alive again? That means you can still go to him again if you have problems, if you have anything you want to ask. And that is the way with Jesus. Jesus died, but he did not remain dead. He rose again from the dead, and you and I can begin to approach him because he is alive. In this world, there are many faiths that are fertile. Okay? Reason being is the person that they are putting their faith in is still in the tomb, is still buried 6 feet, is still in the grave. He or she is not alive like Jesus. Now the angel's words to Mary Magdalene and the other woman that were there is, he is risen. And what those three words means to them and to us are, this morning, Jesus Christ is truly who he say he is. Jesus had earlier spoken about this day, Luke 24, that is, he would rise. Verse 6, the angels remind these two women, okay, about this. He is not here. He is risen. Remember how he spoke unto you when he was yet in Galilee. So the angels remind these two ladies, you know what? Remember that Jesus spoke about this day to you when he was in Galilee. Okay? That he would die, but he would rise again from the dead. In Matthew twice, Jesus has in fact told them very plainly about this day called Resurrection Sunday. In Matthew 16:21, from that time on, Jesus began to explain to his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem, suffer many things at the hands of the elders, the chief priests, and the teacher of the law, and that he must be killed. And then he says, and on the third day, raised to life. Okay, so Jesus has spoken about today, okay, about himself. He will be killed, but he will be raised back to life. Okay, again, Corinthians say, if he did not raise back to life, if he is not alive, then this gathering, you coming here, I standing here, is useless. No point for us to come to church. Might as well go out somewhere, you know, have our food, read our newspaper, go to a club somewhere. Okay, it's no point gathering here if Jesus is still dead, is still buried, his bones are still there. Okay, if Jesus have not risen again from the dead, because a dead man cannot offer you anything, cannot offer you a good advice, cannot offer you help, cannot offer you a smile, encouragement, cannot offer you wisdom, cannot offer you prayer, cannot offer you anything. A dead person cannot. If I die, I cannot offer to my family or to you anything if I die. Okay? But if I come back alive again, I still can. Amen. Matthew chapter 20, 17 towards 19. Again, he spoke about today, about himself when he dies. Now Jesus was going up to Jerusalem. On the day he took the 12 aside and say to them, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be delivered over to the chief priests and the teachers of the law. They will condemn him to death and will hand him over to the Gentiles to be mocked and to be flogged and crucified. And then Jesus says, on the third day after Good Friday, on the third day after his death, he will be raised to life. Resurrection Sunday today is proof that what he has to say about what he has earlier said is true, in which Jesus has many things to say about who he is, in which most of all them is to say to us that the only way, by the proof of this empty tomb, okay, just as he says, the only way our sins can be forgiven, the only way we can make heaven our home. Many people say there are many paths to heaven, but the Bible says there's only one path to heaven. That's the path through Jesus Christ. The reason being is because when he died on the cross, there's one precious thing called blood. His holy blood, the blood of Jesus Christ, can cleanse you of all your sins. Before I became a Christian, I always thought that doing good works, okay, will cause me to make heaven my home. I do a lot of good works. I give to charity, you know, I help people. But the thing is, I still have sin. It's like wearing a white shirt. Okay? In order the whole shirt to be white, you got to make it all white. You got to clean away the dirt. Suppose your left sleeve is all dirty. Okay? But your white sleeve is clean. Okay? And what happened is you try to do, okay? You try to, in order to make this white shirt completely clean as a white shirt, you got to clean this away. You got to make sure that this one be clean. Then only the white shirt will be really white. If sin is still in our heart, we can do a lot of good works, but sin is still in our heart. Sin is not cleansed. Then before God, we will still look unclean. Before God, we are still a sinner. Before God, if anything happens to you and I, the Bible says life is like a hand breath. Life is this. Life is very short. Life is like a vapor. Here today, gone tomorrow. You and I don't know about tomorrow. Don't ever boast about tomorrow. Don't ever say, tomorrow I'm going to do this. Tomorrow I'm going to maybe like this. No, you don't know about tomorrow. I don't know about tomorrow, whether I'll be still here or not. None of us know. Life is like a hand breath. And if we go, if something happened to us, we will have to stand before a living God, a holy God. And if we stand before a holy God, is this sin, this unrighteousness, these evil motives, this jealousy, this unforgiveness, this hatred of us, okay, this adultery, fornication, this sin, this unclean thing, is it still there? If it's there, then the Lord will say to us, God will say to us, depart from me. I do not know you. Okay, which means person will be cast into hell forever. But if this is not there, okay, then God says, welcome, thou and faithful, into the kingdom of heaven. And this can only not be there through the holy blood of Jesus Christ. Only the blood of Jesus Christ can wash away this sin. Listen to who he himself say he is. John 6:35-48. Jesus says, I am the bread of life. John 8:12 and John 9:5 says, I am the light of the world. John 10:9, Jesus says, I am the door. John chapter 10, 11, I am the good shepherd. John chapter 11, 25, I am the resurrection and the life. John 14, 6, Jesus boldly say, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. John 15, 1, Jesus says, I am the true vine. Twice before his death, in plain language, once in a figurative form, when the Jews asked him to prove his authority to all these things, in which he says to them in John 2, 18 and 19, destroy this temple and I will raise it again in 3 days. He's talking about himself, that on the third day, okay, after he's been killed, on Good Friday, on the third day, he will rise again. And sure enough, 3 days later, on Resurrection Sunday, when they went to the tomb where he was buried, they could not find his body because he has already said what will happen to him. He must be killed and on the third day be raised to life. If you are hungry, he is your bread of life. If you are in darkness, you don't know what to do, he is the light who can enlighten your way for you. If you find yourself unable to get a breakthrough, he is the door that can help you. If you need a trusted servant, a trusted leader, Jesus is the one. He is a good shepherd. Amen. He will truly and sincerely guide you. In these days we are living in, scam everywhere. You know, so hard to trust people. Okay? They're scam, even family members, you know, scamming own family members in these days we're living in. So hard to trust people. But Jesus, he is worthy to be trusted. Amen. He'll never fail you. You can trust him with your own, with your whole life, with your marriage, with your children. You can trust him that he will be there to be a good shepherd to you. If you are lifeless because of what is happening to you, he can resurrect your life. He can bless your life. He can prosper your life. He can give you another chance. He can begin to make, improve your life. If you're lost, he's the way, the truth, and the life. If you need someone to cling on to, he is the one. What is resurrection about, you may ask? It's about who he say he is. And no other faith can claim what Jesus claimed except Jesus Christ himself. Secondly, Resurrection Sunday means we can expect change to happen. When Mary Magdalene and a certain woman went in, what seems to be a difficult 2.5 days of grief, they were in grief. Jesus died on Good Friday. And for 2.5 days, these who loved Jesus, they were broken. They were in sorrow. They were in pain in heart. But on Resurrection Sunday, their pain turned to joy. Their sorrow turned to delight. Their sadness turned into excitement and heavenly and unforgettable. They went to a place where Jesus was buried. And they went with sadness. But when they went there, they came out of the tomb beaming with joy to what they had just experienced. John 21 tells us that Mary Magdalene and others were walking to the burial place of Christ. But as soon as they were there, they were running back to the disciples and then running back to the tomb. Upon entering the tomb of Jesus, saw only the napkin, only the linen wrapped orderly, but they could not find the body of Christ. Change begins to take place in the inside of them. And this is the beauty of faith in Jesus Christ, who has risen from the dead. That is, a change can take place. And one of the change that can take place is in the inside of you. Maybe this morning in this place, you're holding a lot of pain in your heart. Maybe this morning you're holding a lot of guilt inside you. No one sees. They look on you on the outside and you got that smile, but you know deep inside you there's a scar there. There's a brokenness there. Nobody knows, maybe. And you're thinking, you know what, this pain can never go away. But I want to share with you the good news. Amen. There's a day called Resurrection Sunday. Things can change. Your heart can be changed from a sad heart to a joyful heart. Amen. The inside you can be transformed. You begin to think differently. You begin to see people differently. You'll be able to forgive. You'll be able to forget. You'll be able to run the race again. You will be able to dust the sadness from your heart, from your life, and rise up from the failure of things and begin to rise up again, because there's a change that can happen in the inside of you. From changing the way you think, to the way you behave, to the way you view life, the way you look at your enemies, you begin to bless them instead of becoming bitter with them. The way you look at the world, the way you look at your marriage, the way you look at money, the way you look at the world and all that is in the world. Resurrection Sunday is about a change. I was listening to this testimony of this Hong Kong gangster testify in Chinese, in Cantonese, Hong Kong Cantonese. And this Hong Kong gangster, he's a hardcore gangster. In Hong Kong, prostitution, money laundering, extortion. He's a real gang, beating up people, killing up people. One day he met Jesus Christ. Okay. One day he had an encounter with Jesus Christ. It totally changed him. Okay. It totally transformed him. He began to stop doing all those things. He began to also begin to witness to his gangsters' friends. He began to tell them about Jesus. And many of those gangsters, they got saved as well. Under the beauty of being a Christian, when you accept Christ into your life, you change. You begin to transform. My brother-in-law is a great example of that. He was a businessman, very prideful. Never liked him when he comes to our house. He married my elder sister. He's a rich businessman and very prideful. You know, one day he came in transformed. He came in smiling. He came in buying fucking chow, you know. He will give us to eat fucking chow la, and he'll buy, you know, dim sum la. Say, what happened to him? And then come to know he's going to church. His testimony was he would used to stand outside the church and look inside. See, why are these people, what are these people doing? He'll look from the outside, hey, oh, they're singing, and they look very happy. What is happening to them? He will stand outside for a while with a cigarette like that. And then he'll walk away. But then he come back again and he'll look inside the church, you know, and see what they're doing. What is happening to these people? They're so joyful, so real. And one day he himself walked inside. He got saved. He became a Christian. And I say, wow, what happened to him? His life totally changed. Very humble man. Changed. Very likable. Very transformed. Very friendly. Not prideful anymore. And I realized that Jesus, in the inside of him, working on the inside of him, and changing him from the outside. Thank God Jesus rose again from the dead. Amen. If not again, it's useless for us to be here. It's useless for you to give your money. It's useless for me to be here. But it's not useless. Amen. is not futile. It is profitable. Amen. Because Jesus rose again from the dead. The inscription that marks the tombstone of Jesus Christ is inscribed by the holy angels. He is not here. He is risen. And thank God Jesus rose again from the dead. Amen. I want to read bow. Goodness of God. Goodness of God. Okay. On every head bow, every eyes closed before the living God. And this morning here in this place, maybe you do not know Jesus. And God has been dealing with your heart. God has been dealing with your heart about tomorrow. That is, if you die today, where would you go? Some people believe that heaven or hell is a nice place. You still can work. You still can have a chauffeur driving you around. You still got a house, a bungalow. You still got money to spend. They believe in hell. But they believe that hell is just like earth. No. The Bible tells us that hell is a burning place. Fire. Hell is where all the devils are. When my sister passed away of cancer, that time I'm not a Christian. My mom told me, don't go downstairs. The coffin for my sister is downstairs. At that time I was 16 years old. My mom says, second night, don't go downstairs. I say, why? Because there will be a spirit coming. Ngautau mami na. It's a head of a horse. And the face of a horse and head of a cow. The spirit will come and take your sister. Wow, I say, what is that? No? My mom told me that. Don't go downstairs. A demon, a head of a cow, a face of a horse is going to come and take her with chains and take her down. Huh? They're scary. Hell is a burning place with demons living there. But Jesus, He came to save you and I from that place. He wants you to make heaven your home. Heaven is totally different. Eternal joy. If you are here, maybe God is speaking to you about your tomorrow. You're thinking, well, you know, I'm planning 10 years ahead, 50 years ahead. But you do not know about tomorrow. Last week, my uncle, 3 o'clock, he has a heart attack. 5 o'clock in the hospital, he died. He went into eternity. If you do go to eternity, will you be ready to meet God? Without Jesus, we will not be ready to meet God. He will say, I do not know you. Anyone here, you want to say, Pastor, could you pray for me? I'm not a Christian. I don't know Jesus. I'm not saved. My sins are still with me. I feel very guilty. I want my sins forgiven. Anyone here, you lift up your hands and say, here's my hand, Pastor. Could you pray for me? Anybody here? Before we sing this song, anybody here? Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Okay, amen. Let's stand to our feet. Let's sing this song before we have our light refreshment. I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me. All my days
I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Let's lift up our hands and worship Him.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. You have led me through the fire. In darkness nights, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I know you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God
all my life. Hallelujah.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. In every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Your goodness this morning. Your goodness is running after,
running after me.
Your goodness is running after,
running after me.
With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, running after me. Your goodness. Your goodness is running after, running after me. Your goodness is running after, running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything.
Your goodness is running after, running after me.
All my life.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness
of God. I will sing.
I will sing of the goodness of God.
I will sing.
I will sing of the goodness of God.
Let's give Him a big clap this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, let's bow our heads. Brother Go, can you help close in the word of prayer? Yes, Lord. Yes, amen. Yes. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Let's pray for the food. Amen.